is News 8 Morning Extra.
I know a lot of you have made those New Year resolutions, right? To eat better, to be working out. But what's a guy or gal to do with all those diets out there? There's so many diet fads, right? We've got Tara Coleman, nutritionist, with us out here. And we've seen studies, Tara, thanks for coming in, by the way, that talk about these diets and some of the best and worst diets out there. In fact, there was a recent study that the Mediterranean diet is at the top. Talk about this study a little bit, and then we'll break down some great hacks for our dieters out there.
So this study came out last week.
Right.
And basically ranked diets from best to worst.
Okay.
The top three diets were the Mediterranean, DASH, and Flexitarian.
And what about the Mediterranean is so good for us?
Well, what this study looked at is they looked at heart health.
Mm-hmm.
It looked at prevention for diabetes. But it also looked at some interesting things like sustainability.
Okay.
Obviously looked at short-term and long-term weight loss and being able to eat with your family and being able to eat in social situations. So it had a pretty holistic view of the best and worst diets.
What was on the bottom of that pile?
The bottom was keto.
Okay. And the reason keto just is not the best right now?
Well, if you're looking at heart health, if you're looking at diabetes prevention, if you're looking at sustainability, it just fails. It falls short in this.
Gotcha. Well, we don't want to just talk about studies. As you're at home and you're thinking about your diet, we want to give you some hacks, some simple solutions for maybe the more beginner dieters and the more advanced. So you brought in some great examples here, Tara. Let's start here with our veggies.
Well, there's a lot of common rules with all of these, and really the best diets are based in plants.
Mm-hmm.
They're getting 50 to 70% of their calories in plants. So that's your fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. That's where we get our vitamins, our minerals, our fiber, and honestly, a lot of our flavor. And so I know not everyone loves vegetables.
Sure.
A quick tip with that, if you don't like vegetables, roasting them or barbecuing them is going to make them a little bit more sweet.
Oh, I love barbecuing my veggies.
Yeah, it brings out that sweetness
of it.
Yeah,
it does. So a basic hack for someone to get their veggies.
Basic hack, try a serving of veggies once a day.
Okay, that's simple enough.
That's simple enough.
A little red pepper. I mean, that's simple. Some carrots, maybe.
Pick the one that's easiest for you.
For more advanced dieters?
More advanced, I would have a fruit or vegetable at every single meal and snack.
Every serving.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you're going to be spending a little time in the produce aisle when you're going to be grocery shopping.
Look at how pretty it is.
But it goes a long way. Yeah, and all those colors. Okay, we're moving over here. We've got some eggs over here, and basically your non-meat options, right?
Yes. So another common theme is these diets really focused on vegetarian proteins. Now, that's not to say that, you know, chicken and beef or anything like that is bad.
Sure.
I'm an omnivore. I eat all of those things.
Yes.
But in our culture, we're a little hyper-focused on those,
totally.
Right? And so there's a lot of other wonderful sources of protein, such as beans, eggs, fish. You get some really great omega-3 fatty acids, and they're actually very, very satiating.
Sure, sure. Like a tuna fish sandwich instead of loading it, the ham and the turkey and all that.
Exactly.
Gotcha. The brisket.
Now, there's some fun ways of doing it. If you're not a beans person, you know, there's some great lentil-based pastas. You can do some toasted chickpeas. So, again, figure out where your starting point is.
Gotcha.
You don't need to go from zero to, you know, nothing but beans overnight.
Basic hack here?
Basic hack would be have once a week do a plant-based meal.
Okay. Okay,
you know,
I think that's simple enough.
Protein.
We can do that for our advanced folks.
Advanced once a day.
Once a day.
Get
in on that once a day. Okay, avocados, nuts. We've got some coconut oil over here. What is this all about?
So another common theme is they really focused on healthy fats.
Right.
Now, healthy fats are critical from a brain health standpoint. They make you satisfied. They taste really, really good.
Sure.
But they also, when you focus on adding healthy fats, you also take out some of the unhealthy fats.
Okay.
These are fats found in fried food. These are fats found when we have too many omega-6 fatty acids, things along those lines.
Basic for this one?
Basic for this one is get rid of your vegetable oils, get rid of your canola oils, and add in avocado, olive oil, and coconut oil.
Advanced dieters.
Every single time you eat, have 1 to 2 thumb sizes of a healthy fat.
Thumb sizes, okay, that's the trick there. And this might be potentially our favorite part right here.
This is where I make friends.
Exactly. Well, you know, and this is a good point here, Tara. We can't be too strict.
Right.
Right? We gotta live a little. So talk about the wine and the chocolate.
So they also incorporated, you know, most of them had alcohol and chocolate. And that's not to say you should go out boozing it up.
Right, no, moderation.
Yeah, right. But food isn't just fuel. It's community. It's social. It's how we connect. And as humans, we are social beings.
Sure.
And so a lot of these extreme diets really make you isolate, right?
Sure.
And they take that away. And if you look at when people fall off of diets, they fall off of it because they don't like the way it tastes. They're not getting any pleasure.
Yeah.
Or they go out in a social situation and lose their minds and feel like they can't do anything, and then then eat all of the chips and salsa.
Totally. Tara, thanks so much for coming in and walking us through all that. And Heather, it's a reminder that you're supposed to start on this side of the table, concentrate on this side of the table, and then maybe a little of this. I think the holidays is like focused so much on this, and then these are kind of afterthoughts. You know what I mean?
It's as if you were at all my holiday parties.
Yeah, that's exactly. Yeah. So let's start on this side of the table now. New year.
Got it.
New you.
Okay.
Thank you, Tara.
Thank you so much.
Thank you both.